In this tutorial, we're going to take a deeper look into magically extending images or outcropping. Let's start with this panoramic photo that I created. We want to extend the top and bottom. So let's choose the crop tool. Now let's hold down the Alt and the Option key as I drag. That'll do the top and bottom at the same time. Let's make it much bigger as I want to extend the top and bottom. We'll do that first and then we'll look at some other options. So let's just grab our selection tool and let's just go inside the image a little bit. We're going to inverse this. This is Command Shift I. So now we've selected outside those areas. Now what we want to do is we're just going to let the AI fill this and extend it. So we're going to choose Generative Fill. At this point, we're not going to put any text in. We're just going to hit Generate once more. So it's actually doing this in the cloud on the computer farm. And look at that. There's the result. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. And we can see under the variations in the properties panel, we have three different variations. Now, one of the things you might notice is the resolution at this moment is quite low. So what it's doing right now is it's limited to 1K. So if you want to get a better result, is do it in pieces. So we could grab the bottom here, and then we're just going to hit Generative Fill and let it generate on its own. So it's not sharing that 1K with the top. And you can see we get different results. Let me just move this bar to the top. By the way, you can pin this bar. If you hit this little menu and choose Pin Bar Position, we can pin that to the top. Now let's look at the options. 2, 3 options there. Definitely better resolution. Now let's do this in smaller pieces. As you can see there, that's definitely better. Let's grab another piece here. All right, so we've regenerated those different portions of the image, but there's other things we can do. Let's grab the sky first of all. And then we're gonna hit Generative Fill, and this time we're gonna put some text in. Let's do dark, moody sky and then hit generate. So now we're prompting it and telling it what we want it to do rather than just letting it fill. And here we get some different options. I think I'm going to go for the first one. And notice it also respects the lighting direction. Now there's other things that we can do in here which are kind of nuts. Let me show you this. And then we'll do another outcropping example. So this time we want a lake. And here we have three options of lakes. I like the second option, but as you can see, it's very realistic. And notice it also gets the proper reflections. All right, let's try something quite challenging. Let's do the street scene. So I'm going to zoom out. And I'm going to extend this. We're going to outcrop this quite a lot. Let's see how good this really is. So we're just going to grab the magic wand tool to select that white area. So we can just click in the options here and we're going to choose Expand Selection. 25 pixels will be fine. And just let it generate by itself. And look at that. There's another option. And there's a third option. All right, let's go from here and we're going to see if we can prompt it a little bit. So why don't we say brick wall with moss. That one wasn't very accurate. This one is definitely a lot more what we're looking at. And then there's a third option. I like option 2, but let's look at some of the features in here. We could generate again. So I'm going to choose the image that I like the best, and then we're going to hit generate again and let it create 3 more variations. All right, let's click in the second one and a third one. And right there, that's what I was thinking of in the first place. So sometimes you got to give it more than one go. Now, the interesting thing is if we go to the properties panel, you'll see that the original 3 generations were there. Then when we regenerated it again, we got 3 more. Every time I hit generate, it's going to create 3 more variations. Now, if you want to remove a variation, you just hit the X up there and that will remove that variation from the image and also, you know, free up a little bit of memory. Now, the other thing that this does, each time you create a new selection and you create a new prompt, it creates a prompt layer. You can see the icon here that says, hey, this layer has a prompt. And if we click on it, it will show us what the prompt is. In this case, because we didn't add a prompt, we just extended it. It just shows, you know, just blank. If I click on the top one, the brick wall with moss will show up. When I click on that top one, notice those variations are there. But when I click in the bottom, you'll also get those other variations. So the variations stay. Now, if I was to choose one of these other variations, it wouldn't match anymore. Notice, see how it doesn't match? Because when we created the new version of it on top, that new version kind of worked with it. But because these are layers, you know, you could also go in, you could use traditional tools, and you could mask and do those kind of things with it. Check out my video here where I show you all the different things we can do. And I'm going to do more of these short videos where we go more in depth in a single aspect of this tool. If you want to follow those, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. Till next time, I'll see you at the cafe.